Editing your first 360 video can be a bit confusing. This video will walk you through the entire process from shooting, editing, and uploading to YouTube, all with the LG 360. The normal footage coming straight from the SD card cannot be edited into a 360 video. It just appears as two large circles, but it is very easy to convert into a flat image that can be edited. There are two ways to convert this image. The first is using your cell phone. The camera connects with Wi-Fi, so find the clip you want to edit, Wi-Fi that clip over to your device, and then it'll be converted on the device itself. The transferred clips that you pull from your phone onto your computer will not appear as two large circles. It'll be a flat image that you can edit. The second way is with a free desktop app from LG's website. I will link it in the video description below this video. Download that, and then you can see here what the raw footage looks like directly from the SD card. It's just two huge circles that don't look 360-ish at all. Drag and drop that footage onto the LG 360 desktop app and it will convert into editable files for you. The app will drop the finished files into the same folder, with the word result in the file name. Then you can view the 360-degree footage in the LG 360 desktop app. If you open the file in a normal video player, you can see that it fills up the entire screen with footage that you can edit with any editing software. I personally use Adobe Premiere, so I'll pull it up in that. This is a 360 video that I made previously of me hiking the Yosemite Half Dome. Super sketchy hike. I suggest you watch that video after you're finished with this one. You can see that the LG 360 shoots in 5.1 surround sound, so when you are done cutting and splicing up your footage and you're ready to export the final clip, make sure you switch your audio to the 5.1 surround instead of stereo. And make sure that you find the correct bitrate of the file so that Adobe doesn't compress the footage for you. YouTube does enough of that on its own. Because the original files you can see here in the details are just shy of 22 megabits a second. So that will maintain the quality and the integrity of the video as I render, before YouTube compression comes in and smashes it all up. Now YouTube has no way of knowing that the footage is a 360 degree video unless we tell it. So we have to download the free 360 video metadata app from YouTube. I'll link this program in the video description as well. It is a very simple app. You just open the finished file that you exported from your video editor and check the spherical box. You don't need to worry about any of the other options and then hit save as. The program will add the word injected into the file name and you can save it wherever you want. I like leaving it next to the original file. Just drag and drop that file into the YouTube uploader and boom, you are ready to rock. In order to view these 360 degree videos, you need to be watching from the Google Chrome web browser or from the YouTube app on your phone, iPhone, or Android. Anywhere else will just display a flat video, which isn't as fun to watch. Please subscribe if you learned something new today, and hit that thumbs up if you're in a good mood. Check out the Yosemite 360 degree video I made, and another video of me flying teeny drones with Sully Breaks, Kian Toomey, and Gary Turk. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around.